Now that we have a baby, I've been thinking about building some sort of baby soothing device, basically a rocking machine. And I need a low-speed motor for that, some kind of gearhead motor. And I was thinking maybe this old cordless drill, battery's long gone in that, and to run it off a benchtop power supply. And that is close to the right speed, but it's very loud, and these brush motors would wear out very quickly. So then I was thinking maybe some kind of AC gearhead motor. For instance, like this one, and this one runs at a good speed, but the problem is it's not meant for continuous duty. But then I realized I have this gearbox from an old drill, and I've already experimented with putting a pulley on here. This used to be the motor shaft. It's this flat belt, which is actually from an old 8-track player, and it needs crown pulleys to track, so I made a couple out of plywood. And then we put the belt over both of these. And this is cool how flat belts track on top of the crown. I made a whole video about that effect. So this produces a pretty slow motion and it's not too loud. In fact, if I picked up the motor, it's even quieter. But I want this to actually ideally run even slower because I'd like to have a cam on here so I can produce more complicated motion patterns for the baby. So maybe this turntable motor might actually be enough power, and this motor only draws about 8 watts when it's running, and it's super quiet. I just cut out a smaller pulley, and now I need to sand a crown onto it. Unfortunately, it's a bit too loose, so I'm going to try to get it tighter by putting some plastic foil in the hole. That's fairly tight. I need to put the motor on this side to spin the drill this way, because otherwise this spiral gear is just going to make this part pop out. So I may just barely have enough power here. So I need to somehow rigidly mount this thing, and I've made this bracket so far. But then I realized it might actually be much better to have this a little bit further off of a base so I could put a bigger cam on here. Maybe if I mount it like this. And so I made this bracket here that goes on here. And then a spacer brings this up like so. I was starting to doubt whether this motor has enough power, so I switched to this motor. This one does draw about 3 times as much power, but it has much more power in the output, and it's also fairly quiet. But it's twice the RPM, so I had to make a much smaller pulley, especially because I wanted to go for a lower RPM. So let's see how that works. It's pretty good. Reasonable amount of torque. And I was also thinking it would be good to have some kind of support for this shaft right here, and I found this bushing that just fits. And so I made this holder for it. Bushing goes in here, and then a washer and a screw to make sure that bushing doesn't come out. Well, that's working a bit better, but it's a bit loud, and I think imprecise bearings like this could really use a bit of grease. Nothing like grease for things with play in them. I just don't want to get my wood too dirty. Oh yeah, that's better already. Cool thing is, I have a two-speed gearbox. Okay, before I get too fancy, I thought I'd just try it out with a crank. See if this thing works at all. Now I need to make some rockers for the bassinet. It would be easier to just put a bigger block in the middle, but by applying the bending moment at the end, I actually get a curve that's much closer to circular this way.
Wow, it actually works.
Well, it's been a week since I built this, and we end up using this quite a lot. So I've modified it so it fits mostly underneath the bassinet, and it even anchors to one of the runners so it doesn't slide around, and I had to add a little fan here to keep this motor from overheating. And here it is, set in high gear and configured for a large swing. I think we'll save that mode for emergencies.